Hello again, Julian. Hanna, Managing Director of Mod Resources, is with us here at Proactive Investors in London. A warm welcome to you, Julian. Good to see you here. Now, you're representing a Botswana copper explorer and developer. And in fact, I think you were telling me earlier, the biggest in Botswana. Tell us where you're at and what your targets are.
Yep. Thanks, Polly. Nice to meet you. And thanks very much for the chance to update our shareholders on what we're up to. We've been very busy. You know, Mod is a company that's on a mission to become a substantial copper producer in Botswana. We are the largest explorer, we're the largest license holder, and we're looking to develop our first mine. When last interviewed, we were looking towards a feasibility study for completion at the end of March. We actually announced that completion on the 28th of March, just last Thursday, and here we are today in London following up on that. The purpose of the feasibility study was to really demonstrate the potential not only of this initial startup mine project for us, but also to demonstrate the potential of the whole copper belt in which we
And tell explore. Us a bit more about that. I mean, it is a substantial resource, isn't it? You were giving me an idea of the sizes earlier.
Yeah, from the pre-feasibility study we announced 12 months ago, we've increased that by 60% from 21 million tonnes up to 34 million tonnes. That'll be within an open pit mine. With that goes a big increase in the amount of copper and silver contained within that reserve, an ore reserve. And the feasibility study metrics are really outstanding for a project of this type. It's a large deposit, but it's also very wide, very shallow depth, so we are able to mine it by open pit. We're looking at an 11.5-year project here, production of around about 28,000 tonnes of copper per annum. And a 3 million tonne per annum process plant. We're very comfortable about the conservative nature of the assumptions we've taken. So we've adopted a $3.08 per pound copper price, which is fairly modest compared with some of our peers. But the project survives all of that very comfortably. Margins, we're producing copper, according to the feasibility study outcomes, at $1.56 a pound US. Which puts us in the lowest quartile. It puts us in a very good spot compared with global copper production.
And grades are king, of course. What are your grades like?
Grade is 1% mine life. Within that, there's very high grade zones. It's a big deposit, up to 100 metres true width, which is and a very favourable geometry for open pit mining. Importantly too, it's called T3. I should say that very clearly at the start, but T3 itself sits within what we call the T3 expansion project area, around about 1,000 square kilometres. We've demonstrated potential for additional copper in satellite deposits in the surrounding area. A lot of success during 2018, just teasing out some of that potential. And T3 itself will represent, we hope, into the future here, a processing hub for ore from other deposits. So while we're looking to target initially from T3, 28,000 tonne of copper a year, our own internal targets are beyond that. So we're looking at ways to build a real copper company here.
And to give investors an idea of just how big this resource is, I mean, you can drive for 200 kilometres, can't you, and you're not through it.
That's our licence holding, yeah. We run all the way to the Namibian border from where we are. And I should point out, there's infrastructure is wonderful in our part of Botswana. There's a highway that runs down the centre of the copper belt. There's a township called Hunzi, where we're establishing a village for 400 people initially. The first stage of that's already completed. We're getting a lot of support from the local community to develop, train, and encourage a legacy, if you like, of mining in this district.
So the T3 position then, your primary resource, located in your license holding, as you described. So you're hinting there at the other resources that are of interest to you. What else are you looking at?
We've got immediate potential below the open pit at T3, what we call the T3 underground project. So we've conducted some preliminary sort of scoping level underground studies. We need further drilling to drill that out, and that's a high priority for us. Beyond that, 8 kilometres from T3, we're very fortunate there's a target we call the A4 dome, and this is a huge target. We've drilled 20 holes to date, but again, the signs are very promising there as well. So one of our priorities in the next 6 months, apart from getting T3 through to a decision to mine, will be to start resource drilling out the A4 dome and other targets in the immediate region of T3.
So multiple projects and over many targets. What are you going to be focusing on over the next 6 months or so? What can we see in terms of news flows?
Primarily on T3, we're looking at decision to mine within the next 3 to 4 months. We're looking at mining license application. So while I'll be in Botswana at the end of this month and looking to submit our feasibility study to the Department of Mines. And we have an environmental social impact assessment study, which has been running for many months to a very high standard. We're bringing the very best we can into this country. And we'll be submitting that as well. Once that is delivered, then we can start applying for a mining license. We get very strong support in country from the government and a local level. So that will see T3 getting its own life, and the financing for that project, we're already well down the path of securing debt funding, but also potential for other sorts of non-debt funding to help this project into development.
So you've delivered a great overview of MOD for investors not familiar with your portfolio and what you're doing in Botswana.
Yep.
You're talking to them now. Mm. What is your message to investors who haven't heard about you before and perhaps are interested in taking a position?
I think what sets MOD apart from the rest is that we really dominate a copper belt. We have a very large land holding. We have 11,500 square kilometres. It's had very, very little exploration prior to the discovery of T3, only 3 years ago. T3 has demonstrated the potential. We're now rapidly understanding the geology. We have, using the world's best technology, electromagnetics in effect, to define the subsurface geology. We drill a lot of our exploration drilling is based on drilling EM anomalies, and we've had great success on that in the last 12 months. So I think we can demonstrate that not only are we able to bring a mine into production, but we're also able to expand the opportunity for investors and give them exposure to copper in a very good five-star jurisdiction and with good infrastructure. We're not having to install roads. We're not having to ford rivers. We don't have to climb mountains. This is very friendly. It's very favourable to mining jurisdiction.
And just lastly, the world needs copper right now. World needs copper.
And I think people are undercalling the demand for copper and assuming that the current supply will continue. Well, there's a lot of pressure on copper production right now.
Well, Julian Hanna, do come back and keep telling us the story, updates on T3 and so on. But for the moment, thanks very much indeed.
Thanks very much.